Dear viewers, welcome back to our channel. On the stage of modern warfare today, the impact of unmanned vessels is undeniable. From the successful sinking of the Russian Black Sea Fleet's landing ship Caesar Kunikov by the 13th Special Forces of the Ukrainian Intelligence Agency, to the operational tests of unmanned vessel formations in the South China Sea, unmanned vessels are redefining the rules of naval warfare in unprecedented ways. This revolutionary transformation not only highlights the potential of maritime strategy for smaller nations, but also challenges major military powers worldwide. However, the rise of unmanned vessels has not been smooth sailing. It has raised a series of critical questions worth pondering. Does the technological development of unmanned vessels signify a fundamental shift in the maritime military balance? In the face of the threat posed by unmanned vessels, what is the future of traditional navies? And can humanity effectively respond to this emerging threat, or will it be replaced by it? With these challenges and reflections in mind, let us explore the profound significance of unmanned vessels for modern naval warfare. Do you remember the recent incident where the Ukrainian Special Forces unmanned vessel sank the Russian Black Sea Fleet's landing ship, Caesar Kunikov? The unit responsible for this victory is the 13th Special Forces, a subsidiary of the Ukrainian Intelligence Agency. This isn't the first time Caesar Kunikov has been hit. 2 years ago, it was hit by a Circle-U missile launched by the Ukrainian military, sinking the Saratov landing ship moored nearby, causing significant damage to Caesar Kunikov. However, the Russian military repaired it and put it back into service. Unbelievably, 2 years later, Caesar Kunikov still couldn't escape its fate of being sunk. Why couldn't the Russian military stop the unmanned vessels? What insights does the sinking of Caesar Kunikov offer for China? If unmanned aerial vehicles have changed land warfare, making tanks no longer the kings of the battlefield, then unmanned vessels have completely reversed the feeling of powerlessness for smaller countries in controlling the seas. Ukraine is a country without a navy, yet it has made the Russian Black Sea Fleet unwilling to show its face. The Russian Black Sea Fleet has only 6 large landing ships, and 3 have been sunk, with the remaining 3 damaged and no longer daring to venture out to sea. In human history, it has never happened that a country without a navy annihilated a powerful Black Sea fleet. If things continue this way, Ukraine may very well create a miracle in naval warfare. The reason Ukraine, without a navy, can defeat the Russian Black Sea fleet lies in the comprehensive technological backwardness of the fleet, not just one ship but all ships. Caesar Kunikov is a Soviet-era alligator-class tank landing ship that entered service in the 1980s, more than 40 years ago. It's a truly outdated warship. It can carry 10 main battle tanks and 190 landing soldiers or 24 armored vehicles, and 170 landing soldiers with emergency medical evacuation capabilities. However, the Russian Black Sea Fleet does not have the capability to conduct amphibious landing operations because it lacks aircraft carriers and amphibious landing ships. Without aircraft carriers for fixed-wing aircraft operations or amphibious landing ships for helicopter operations, and without air superiority in modern amphibious operations, it's impossible to successfully land. Even coastal defense missile batteries alone are enough to defend the coastline. The Russian military never attempted amphibious landing operations in Odessa, and that's the reason. The alligator-class tank landing ship has very poor defense, with only a quad-mounted anti-aircraft missile system and 2 twin-mounted 57mm main guns. This means it has almost no close-range anti-ship capability. Yet it's a 4,000-ton class large landing ship, an easy target. The Magura V-5 unmanned vessel developed independently by Ukraine is small in size, semi-submersible, highly concealed, fast, and has a small radar cross-section. It often conducts nighttime raids, making it difficult for the Russian military to defend against. Compared to unmanned aerial vehicles, it also has the advantage of carrying heavier payloads. The payload of a typical suicide drone is only about 50 kilograms. While an unmanned vessel can carry up to 1,000 kilograms. Unmanned aerial vehicles mainly attack the upper structures of ships and may not sink them immediately, but unmanned vessels specifically target the underwater parts of ships. Once hit, they can cause flooding or detonate the ammunition magazine, posing a much greater threat to ships than unmanned aerial vehicles. The most notable case is when Ukrainian unmanned vessels infiltrated the northern Black Sea and attacked the Crimean Bridge. They not only had to accurately locate the Crimean Bridge, but also continuously change their course to evade radar detection by the Russian military to launch the final deadly blow. Ukraine alone cannot produce such advanced unmanned vessels. It requires support from NATO technologies such as satellite navigation, global communication, intelligent decision-making, and automatic tracking. We can see that Iran, North Korea, and Turkey can all manufacture decent unmanned aerial vehicles, but none can produce advanced unmanned vessels. In the Red Sea region, Houthi militants cannot pose a lethal threat to US warships. On the one hand, the defensive capabilities of US warships, such as Aegis-equipped vessels, are much stronger than those of Russian warships. On the other hand, Houthi militants do not have advanced unmanned vessels. In terms of technological sophistication, unmanned vessels far surpass unmanned aerial vehicles. For example, Iran's Shahed 136 drone follows fixed planned routes based on pre-made maps, with poor flying accuracy, making it unsuitable for precision attacks. It is suitable for large-scale aerial bombardment and indiscriminate attacks. However, unmanned vessels require high precision and maneuverability. They don't follow fixed routes but autonomously adjust their course based on the target's position, autonomously select targets for ambush. Even Russia itself cannot produce a practical type of unmanned vessel. Only two countries, the United States and China, can independently produce unmanned vessels. The technology of unmanned vessels was first developed by the United States. As early as 2018, the United States commissioned the Sea Hunter unmanned vessel, the world's second operational unmanned vessel, mainly used for anti-submarine warfare. The Ukrainian military's unmanned vessels conduct suicide anti-ship operations. The world's first operational unmanned vessel was developed by Israel, called the Seagull, unmanned, and missile boat. China's unmanned vessel technology is not inferior to that of the United States. In July 2023, China conducted a test of a formation of 56 unmanned vessels in the South China Sea, leading the way in the coordinated operation of unmanned vessels. China's unmanned vessels have ushered in a military era. It all began with Yunju Intelligence Company, which developed the L-30A unmanned vessel, equipped with an electro-optical surveillance system and a 12.7mm automatic weapon station, primarily used for maritime patrol, interception, and counter-terrorism operations. At the recent Liège Defense Expo, China showcased a stealth unmanned vessel equipped with four-phased array radars capable of launching anti-ship missiles, which is almost the technological ceiling for unmanned vessels. From a practical perspective, the Ukrainian military has overturned modern naval warfare with suicide unmanned vessels. However, in the future, China should not only develop suicide unmanned vessels but also develop anti-submarine unmanned, anti-aircraft unmanned, electronic warfare unmanned, reconnaissance unmanned, and other types of unmanned vessels. The emergence of unmanned aerial vehicles and unmanned vessels will overturn human naval tactics. Unmanned weapons can greatly reduce the gap in population and force through information technology and industrial-scale leadership, allowing small countries to defeat large countries. In the future, there will be fewer and fewer soldiers, and instead of human soldiers, there will be massive unmanned aerial vehicles, unmanned vessels, unmanned tanks, unmanned turrets, and so on. These seemingly futuristic scenarios are accelerating into the real world. In the era of intelligent warfare, human wave tactics will completely exit the stage of history. In conclusion, let me summarize today's video, hoping it has provided you with some inspiration and value. As a seasoned blogger, I deeply understand the impact of geopolitics and arms races on world peace. The recent incident of Ukrainian unmanned vessels sinking the Russian Black Sea fleet once again reminds us that the advancement of military technology is changing the global strategic landscape. However, I strongly oppose excessive arms races and geopolitical confrontation. In today's world, what we need more is cooperation and understanding, not confrontation and military expansion. What we need is joint efforts to address global challenges such as climate change, poverty, and disease spread, rather than wasting resources on military equipment races. Therefore, we must be vigilant against the traps of geopolitics and strive to seek peaceful solutions through diplomacy and negotiation to build a peaceful and prosperous world together. Finally, I'd like to ask, shouldn't we reconsider the arms race in international relations and seek more peaceful solutions? Can we achieve long-term stability and prosperity in the world through multilateral cooperation and diplomatic efforts? Let's think together and work together to create a better future. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments section. That's all for today's video. See you next time with more exciting content. Goodbye.